time on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? What American comedian suggested that his epitaph read, I'd rather be in Philadelphia?
And doubt the 50-50 will be over myself. Don't go with it. I mean, stuff to risk $15,000. Not an answer. Can I ask the audience again?
No, all your lifelines are gone, unfortunately.
I think the answer is E.
You got it right. And in the fastest time, Matt Phillips, the only one. Now, join us from New York for night 50 of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Thank you very much, everybody. Hello again, everybody, and welcome to another night of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Now, we had a great game going here the other night. Jack Leshner from New York City sang for his money, you may recall that, walked away with $125,000, and then young Bowen Cairns, a high school math teacher and former world pinball champion from Swampscott, Massachusetts, rang up $32,000, a big night. But right now, the news is spreading all over Washington, D.C. and Capitol Hill that Matt Phillips, California Congressman's press secretary, is returning to our hot seat. And welcome back, Matt. Nice
Thank
to have you.
You
here.
Thank you.
Matt's 26. He's single, and he works for a California congressman, as I said. Now, do you think the whole team is watching from maybe his office?
I don't think they're at the office, but they're watching.
Good. That's great. And let me ask you this. You do what Michael J. Fox does for the mayor here of New York City and in Spin City.
Right.
More or less,
well,
right?
Well, there's I guess he's the deputy mayor. There's a chief of staff. I'm the press secretary. Well, it's sort of along the same line.
Well, let me ask you this. Are there any Heather Locklears in your life?
there are a couple that come close, I guess, that you see every once in a while. But, you know, there are some similarities. There's some differences. I don't want to get myself in trouble.
Handle it just like a politician. Incidentally, do you have any political ambition?
No, I just want to. I just enjoy working on the Hill, and I'll just see what comes along.
Good. You're a history major from the University of Virginia, which probably could help you here
tonight. I hope so.
All right, Matt, you've won $2,000. You're 9 questions away from winning the $1 million. Once you reach the $32,000 level, you're guaranteed to leave here with at least that much money. You've got 2 lifelines left to help, 50-50, where the computer will take away 2 of the wrong answers, leaving the correct answer and 1 wrong answer. Finally, you can phone a friend, where our friends at AT&T will help you call anyone anywhere in America to see if they can help you out. And if you're ready, Matt, shall we start? Studio audience, shall we do it? Come on, let's go. Let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. All right, here we go. You've won $2,000. We're going for $4,000, and this is what it looks like. What rock band shares its name with a famous spy plane? R.E.M. Jefferson Airplane. Aerosmith. U2.
One of my favorites, it's you too. Final answer.
Final answer, yes indeed, you're right. You won $4,000. Eight questions away from $1 million, and here it is for $8,000. What comic strip is centered around African-American city kids adjusting to life in suburbia? Jumpstart, Agnes, The Boondocks, Life in Hell.
I think the author of this strip is from the Washington area. I think it's Boondocks. See.
Final answer?
Yeah.
You're right. You won 8,000. Okay, so quickly, we're going for $16,000. Still 2 lifelines intact. Here it is. What was the name of Ross's pet monkey on the TV series Friends? Pepe, Marcel, Pierre, Melvin.
I remember the episodes where he had Marcel as his monkey bee. Final answer.
Final answer, Marcel. You're right again for 16 grand. Matt Phillips, feeling pretty good. It's easier the second night you're here, isn't it?
It's different. I'm trying to remember more from last night, from the time before.
Okay, so here you are, 6 questions away from $1 million. $32,000, and this is it. During his tour of duty in Vietnam, Vice President Al Gore was which of the following? Journalist, cook, paramedic, chaplain.
You can just imagine the comments some of my friends back in Washington are making right now.
Yeah, I'll bet.
He was a journalist, A, final answer.
Final answer, journalist. Yes, he was a journalist, you're right. $32,000. He's on the roll. He's going for 64. He's five away from the million. We'll be right back.
I love Kellogg's Frosted Flakes. See, to me, it's the shapes and the frosting, the way they come together. Let me show you. Let me give you a little quick tour, if you don't mind. Over here, I have some of the Football Hall of Fame quarterbacks. I'm very proud of these guys. That's Johnny Unitas up there, second from the left. He's got the ball back. He's cocked ready to make a throw. And you can see they're blitzing by the expression on his face. Look at the whites of his eyes. Yeah, he came by and saw that and was quite impressed. He said, boy, you got me.
They're great.
There's nothing like the way I feel after a good night's sleep. That's why I love my Tylenol PM. For me, there's just no reason to have trouble sleeping. I take Tylenol PM before bed. It stops my pain and helps me sleep. So I'm ready for another great day.
Uncle Ben's rice bowl. Just 6 minutes in the microwave. A whole new way to satisfy your appetite. Uncle Ben's, a passion for good food.
Howie, think fast.
A piggy bank? I saw you at the phone. Hey, are you trying to tell me something?
Yes, you can buy me this, so what's in this? Let me.
You broke the bank.
That penny is hardly breaking the bank.
At Radio Shack, wireless phones start at only a penny. And now you'll get a free hands-free Jabra ear set to keep both hands on the wheel and a free car adapter with select phones. Hey, great gift for Valentine's, only at Radio Shack.
Wednesday.
Show me the money.
The women are armed with cash.
Drumroll, please.
And the men are gonna give it their all.
Who'd like a bite of this green apple?
It's the first ever two guys and a girl bachelor auction.
$100.
A new Two Guys and a Girl, followed by Norm. See you Wednesday on ABC.
Matt Phillips is our man in the hot seat, Ryan. Congressional press secretary, and nice to see you again, Matt. And your dad. Hi, Jack. How you doing?
Fine, Regis. How are you?
What do you do, Jack?
I'm a trucker.
Trucker. All right, good. Around the East Coast?
Pretty much in the Northeast.
Good for you. All right, now, Matt, be nice if you went all the way to the million, but then you're going to wish you had some legislation in the hopper. eliminating
the federal tax on game show.
There you go, pal.
Too bad my boss isn't on the Ways and Means Committee to get on a fast track. But
well, that's what we need to get done, right? All right, fine. You're doing just terrific here. You won $32,000. You're going for $64,000. Let's play. Here we go. Here it is for $64,000 in the religion of Islam. What is a Hajj? A pilgrimage to Mecca? An evening prayer, a rural mosque, a prayer mat.
Evening prayer, rural mosque, prayer mat. Inclination is that it's a pilgrimage to Mecca.
Still have two lifelines.
Evening prayer, rural mosque, prayer mat. A Hajj to Mecca. Hajj. I'm going to go ahead and say A, pilgrimage to Mecca.
Is this a guess?
No, something's telling me I've heard it before.
All right, so A is your final answer?
Yes, sir.
Boy, you got it. It's the pilgrimage to Mecca. You keep in touch with that something, you'll be all right tonight. All right, you won $64,000. Should you miss in here, you'll be reduced to $32,000. But here it comes for $125,000. What company's longtime mascot is officially known as Bibendum? Parker Brothers? FAO Schwartz? Michelin? Birdseye?
I have no idea. Bibendum. I think FAO Schwartz is a teddy bear or something like that. Michelin, I always thought it was just a Michelin man. Let's see. Bibendum. Can I speculate about the lifelines before committing to using them?
Oh, sure.
Okay. So if I use 50-50, and then they'll phone a friend, they'll choose between two. But if they just don't, if they don't know it, then that might not help a whole lot. I go ahead and use the phone a friend, and...
Who do you want to call? Why don't you call your congressman?
He's busy voting, I'm sure. Floor of the house. Mark. A friend Mark.
And Mark is?
A friend of mine from college.
All right, fine. Let's call Mark. AT&T will get Mark on the line, see if he can help.
Hello?
Hello, Mark?
Yes.
Hi, Regis Philbin here from ABC's Who Wants to Be a Millionaire.
Hi, how are you?
Good, fine. How you doing?
I'm doing okay.
I'm here with Matt Phillips. He needs a little help right now.
I'll see what I can do.
All right, I know you can't see us, but he's already won $64,000 going for $125,000.
Okay.
So when he comes on the line, he'll read you the question and four possible answers, and one of them is the correct answer, okay?
Yes, sir.
All right, Matt, it's all yours. You've got 30 seconds, and they start right now.
What company's longtime mascot is officially known as Bibendum? Parker Brothers, FAO Schwartz, Michelin, or Birdseye?
Bibendum?
Bibendum. B-I-B-E-N-D-U-M.
B-I-B-E-N-D-U-M. Could you read them again?
Parker Brothers, FAO Schwartz, Michelin, Birdseye. 4 seconds.
I think they're going to be Birdseye or Parker Brothers. I'm not sure.
Stick 50-50, please.
Absolutely. Computer, please take away two of the wrong answers from Matt, leaving one wrong answer and the correct answer.
Well, Michelin, I think that's just the Michelin man. I'll take a chance on B.
You're going to lose $32,000 if you don't have it.
So I have $32,000.
That's right, you're absolutely right. You still have $32,000. You're going for it. Your final answer is
D.
D. Birdseye. Darn it, it's Michelin. I'm sorry. Well, all right. So we leave here with $32,000, which is a nice piece of change. Matt, it's been nice meeting you. Nice having
you
here. That old Bibendum. Who'd have thought it?
Huh? By Birdseye.
Yeah. Good luck, pal. Right that way. That was a tough one. Tough luck for poor old Matt, but that really was a tough question. But I do hear there's a very good restaurant called Bibendum in the old Michelin building in London. Not that that's going to help Matt. But right now we've got 10 new contestants ready to go. Who are they tonight? Let's find out. And they are Michael Hunter, Greenville, New York. Tim Ahrens, Alpine, California. Jim Gilligan, West Lafayette, Indiana. Janet McElligott, Lynn, Massachusetts. Lydia Potoff, Minneapolis, Minnesota. Bob Wicked, Granada Hills, California. Mark Griswold, New Orleans, Louisiana. Judy Tigay, West Bloomfield, Michigan. Ken O'Brien, Los Angeles, California. John Marsh, Oakland, California. All right, contestants, congratulations on getting this far. Now, here's how it works. In a moment, a question and four answers will appear on your screens. The winner puts those answers in the correct order in the fastest time will be our next player. Audience, we need complete silence here. Thank you very much. Here comes the question. Put the following U.S. national parks in order, going from west to east. Yosemite, Shenandoah, Hawaii Volcanoes, Yellowstone. Okay, everybody, time's up. Let's see the answer in the correct order, starting in the west. Hawaii Volcanoes, Yosemite, Yellowstone, Shenandoah. That's the correct order. Who did it in the fastest time? And the winner is Jim Gilligan. There you go. All right, stand by now. He's going to play. He's going for a million. We'll be right back.
A significant discovery in eye health may be lutein, a nutrient found in these healthy foods. Now Centrum has the only leading multivitamins with lutein to help maintain your precious sight. Centrum, Centrum Silver, now more complete with lutein.
Take a look at what little angels wear at the JCPenney Baby Sale. Save on these sweet outfits, plus everything else baby needs to be on cloud nine. Now 20 to 30% off in store, catalog, and internet. The JCPenney Baby Sale. It's heavenly.
Let's be honest. There's really no such thing as a gracious winner. You might say things like, nice game, or shake your opponent's hand. But no matter how humble you are on the outside, deep down on the inside, you're saying, I'm better than you are. The Mitsubishi Galant, ranked the number one family sedan under 20 grand by Car and Driver. Better than Accord or Camry. Boy, we just love saying that.
How could we make the Chalupa even better?
You could put nacho cheese sauce on it.
Introducing the Nacho Cheese Chalupa, loaded with our warm, zesty nacho cheese sauce. How do we come up with this stuff? Now just 99 cents. Only at Taco Bell.
There's a place where phones go unanswered, and you can have tea with your high school sweetheart and Cornelius from Planet of the Apes. And you can visit every night with Serta. We make the world's best mattress.
You missed the spot.
Presenting The Day at the Gordon, where racing champion Jeff Gordon and his wife Brooke eat new Fritos chili and scoops, a hearty cup of chili and loads of Fritos corn chips. It's fast. It's filling. It's Fritos. Perfect for people on the go. New Fritos chili and scoops and floppy Joe and scoops. Nothing goes faster.
You thought they'd be friends forever.
You betrayed my trust for a sick joke?
How could you?
Now that could all change.
I'm not talking to you.
An unforgettable hour.
If there's bad feelings here, then we have to work them out, because that's what friends should do.
An all-new Boy Meets World, Friday at 8, 7 Central on ABC.
Bet. Get out of here.
What? You want to dance, old man?
Want strong bones? Calcium may help prevent osteoporosis.
With most compact sport utilities, there's sport, but darn little utility. Durango, however, gives you best-in-class power and passenger room.
Plus, as I'm about to demonstrate...
best-in-class cargo room.
Fellas, little help here.
Now lease a four-wheel drive Dodge Durango for $365 a month.
MSG, monosodium glutamate. Sound good to you? It's not. Say no to MSG. Say yes to Mark Pies Express and take a walk on the healthy side.
She's got a look, a language, and an attitude all her own.
I've got soil, I've got flair.
And you won't see her anywhere but here. Weekdays, right here on the home of the nanny.
What are your chances of becoming a victim? Rate your risk to 9 to 10.
So it's Jim Gilligan in the hot seat right now. Formerly from New York City, graduated from Queens College, taught high school here, moved on to Purdue University, where he's going through some graduate studies.
Yes.
With an eye toward what degree?
PhD in American literature.
Good for you. That's terrific. And I see you brought a friend with you from another graduate student?
Yes.
Dwight?
My buddy Dwight, yeah. He's in the statistics department.
I love your matching beards. Real cute. Really, really attractive.
Thank you.
So you came back to New York unexpectedly, huh?
Yes. I said it'd be a great chance to just come home, even for a weekend.
Sure. Big night in New York last night?
Yep. We literally rubbed elbows with Valerie Harper at the Carnegie Deli.
Not bad elbows.
And then we saw Cabaret last night.
Really? Did you say anything to you? Hey, Rhoda?
No. She was busy filming, but we figured... What the heck?
She's a great lady.
Yeah, she seemed like she was.
And you had a good show last night, so you're back home. All right, Jim, good luck to you. You know about the rules, right? You know about the lifeline, 50-50, ask the audience, phone a friend. It's all here, so if you're ready, Jim Gilligan, let's do it for Purdue. Let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. We begin with the $100 question. Here it is. What two terminals are on a standard automobile battery? Mom and pop, positive and negative, acid and base, good and evil.
Well, it's kind of ironic because a week ago Wednesday I went to start my car and my 3-year battery lasted only 2 years and 9 months. And I needed to buy a new one, so it's B, positive and negative.
You're right, you won $100, Jim. Okay. You got the battery, let's get the rest of the car, okay?
All
for $200,
right.
What part of your heart is said to be warm if something profoundly affects you? Cockles, ventricles, valves, hip.
A, cockles.
Yes, it's the cockles, you're right, for $200. Here it is now for $300. What beverage do nutritional experts widely recommend drinking 6 to 8 glasses of a day? Tea, milk, water, tea.
Water.
Yeah, it's water. You got it right. $300. Here it is now for $500. According to the classic book, The Velveteen Rabbit, how does a child's love affect a toy? It makes the toy pretty. It makes the toy glow. It makes the toy large. It makes the toy real.
I think I'm going to have to ask the audience for help on this one. Maybe.
All right, fine, sure. We can go to the audience. Need a little help here for Jim. On your keypad, choosing A, B, C, or D, please vote now. Well, there you go, 88%.
Right.
Overwhelming with this crowd.
Okay, well...
They say it makes the toy real. What do you think?
I think they're right, and I'm glad I have so many readers in the audience.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go with the audience's answer, Jim.
And your final answer is D?
Yes, it is.
And it's the right answer. Thank you very much, audience.
Thank you.
Okay. Too bad you had to burn a lifeline that early, but you got to stay in the game, too. So here it is for $1,000, Jim. What product is the Radio Flyer Company famous for manufacturing? Rock Band T-shirts, Red Wagons, Weather Balloons, Stereo Systems. Radio Flyer.
The Red Wagons.
He says Red Wagons. He's right for $1,000. We're going for $2,000. Here it is. Which of the following is an Olympic sport? Roller hockey, lacrosse, rugby, beach volleyball.
Thank you.
so many new Olympic sports.
Beach volleyball.
Guess?
An educated one.
All right. Final answer?
Yes.
You got it. For beach volleyball, you're right. $2,000. All right, you're doing good here. Nine away from a million. Here's the $4,000 question. In which state did voters participate in the first presidential caucus of 2000? New Hampshire, Indiana, Iowa, Michigan.
Oh, I know the New Hampshire primary was earlier this week. We haven't voted yet in Indiana. And Michigan hasn't even been in the news. I think my friend Holly would be kind of annoyed at me if I got this wrong. So my answer is C, Iowa.
C, Iowa. Final answer.
Final answer.
It's Iowa. You got 4,000. All right, so he's going for 8,000. Let's see how he does. Come on back. He's got two lifelines left.
Is Wendy's Cheddar Lovers Bacon Cheeseburger fit for royalty?
It's American beef. The Queen will love it, but she'll like it opened up and put on the plate. So I expect she can give it a go.
What did he say?
So I expect she can give it a go.
Charles will enjoy it.
That was my fillet. Definitely be bad too.
Come and try Wendy's Cheddar Lovers Bacon Cheeseburger.
Skin wrinkles after a long bath, and a dollar was donated to Amnesty International. Jeff Moore wondered if it was going to rain, and a dollar was donated to the Shoah Foundation. Visit Britannica.com for free to wonder about anything at all, and we'll donate a dollar to charity on your behalf. You choose from one of seven charities that are working to make the world a better, smarter place, because we couldn't help but wonder what would happen if everyone wondered a bit more. Britannica.com. What's on your mind?
Folks think it's odd you're going around in a dye can. When it's obvious, you taste more like regular Dr. Pepper. But if that's your thing?
It's true. Diet Dr. Pepper tastes more like regular.
This Valentine's Day, she'll love diamonds from K Jewelers. K travels the world hand-selecting only the best for you. Like K's diamond heart pendant, earrings, or bracelets starting from $99.95. With diamonds from K, you will make her very happy.
Discover the secret of the beach. Critics are calling the beach seductive.
Let's come to the beach with me.
A journey to the unexpected. The Beach Radar. Friday, only in theaters.
Good morning, Daddy. I was born here, he said. Watched Harlem grow until colored folks spread from river to river across the middle of Manhattan. Out of Penn Station, dark tenth of the nation. Planes from Puerto Rico and holds of boats, Chico. Up from Cuba, Haiti, Jamaica, in buses mark New York. From Georgia, Florida, Louisiana, to Harlem, Brooklyn, the Bronx. But most of all, to Harlem. Dusty sash across Manhattan.
Wednesday, Norm's really in love this time. There's just a one little problem.
Oh, look, it's your fiancé, the guy you're going to marry.
It's all new. See you Wednesday on ABC.
Sunday, there are 101 spills, 101 chills, and 101 reasons to watch The Wonderful World of Disney on ABC. Glenn Close, in a special event for the entire family, 101 Dalmatians, ABC Sunday at 7, 6 Central.
Jim Gilligan from Purdue University, who's a graduate student there, also a teaching assistant back in New York, unexpectedly and loving it, and I see you got your little New York Mets watch on.
Yeah. This was a gift from a good friend of mine, my friend Sue, whom I've known since I was about 9 years old.
Uh-huh.